I get to bring up another special person. And just from what I know, okay, I am really, 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 like, really, really, so I can remember when she first met Nate. And you know her, right? I know her, okay? And so, just as in any relationship, it hadn't always been what I would want it to be. We've had our bumps in the road, but I think all relationships need bumps in the road. They grow you, they grow the relationship, they make you better, they make you appreciate, they make you reflect. And so, regardless, I know her. And so she be looking a little different, and she stand a little taller, you know, she's already tall, beautiful, slim, and statuesque, and beautiful brown eyes that just kind of pierce your soul when she looks at you. And, you know, she be walking, I was like, that's your, you know, what are you doing? You look all right, I'm good. You know, everything was looking.
Thank you. person, never met before, saw the pink Cadillac, saw it as a status symbol. I'm a business guy. Said, I don't feel like talking to nobody, but this is what I do. Pulled on the side of the road, vehicles were driving by, reached over, got a copy of my book, got out of the car, flagged it down, handed the book through the window, talked back and forth, exchanged business cards, got the book back, got out of my car, said, why am I taking this book with me? Stopped the car, got the stop sign, shoot at the light, got out of the car, handed the book back through the window, said, here, read this. If you get any value from it, you can pay me later. Got back in my car, I turned right, she turned left. Business guy. She contacted me on July 26th. She was in Dallas. She told me that she read the book. She shared with 30 Word Records. They all wanted it. Asked me how she could get the book. She got back to Jacksonville, we got up at a car wash, signed the book. She asked me to do a conference call with 200 of her ladies. I said, bring the husband for me. From there, she asked me to do an event. I spoke at her center. And then from there, she hired me to be a business coach. And from that point on, we developed a friendship over scandal and nostrils. Thursday night. Straight platonic, great friends. I'm out doing what I do. But that was the person I always wanted to talk to. And vice versa. So we developed a real good friendship, and that moved us through the end of the year. I entered into a fast January. After the fast, I showed up at the hospital. My wife was in the hospital. She was at Patti LaBelle's concert. She didn't know I was at the hospital. Went there, prayed over him, spoke to him, and told him at that time that she'd be taken care of. When she got back, she was surprised. Her mom knew I was there, but I just showed up. And I think she called her mom. She called her mom, and her mom said, and so I was there when she went through that life-changing moment, but I already had that conversation with her father. We were going to get married on March 4, 2017, but she asked me if we could move the date up, and I said, well, let me think about it. We married on July 2nd, 2016, which would have been his 75th birthday. And that day, every moment of that time since that day, has been amazing. People oftentimes will ask, you know, how's America? Am I easy? It's easy because we're truly best friends. And the foundation of it is that we have mutual respect. As a businessman, I was respectful because I recognized what I knew of the accomplishment that she had because of the status symbol. And then she had respect for me because she had enough respect to hire me. And bringing that into a marriage and genuinely liking each other, there's nothing more. And through all that I've been through in my life, I will tell you that it's truly all of what I mean by life is rich. It's truly my the favor of God in my life as it relates to who He's given to me as mine. And so when she asked me about making a statement about her as my wife, oftentimes we will hear about a virtuous woman. And we'll read that scripture and we'll think about it in the context of something that's unattainable. But I will tell you in the context of that, my wife is a woman of influence, and truly she is and has been this woman that's described in Proverbs 31. She's truly a virtuous woman who leaves her home with integrity, discipline, giftedness. She's a wife, she's a leader, and because she tries to be one, not because she tries to be one, but because of who she actually is. Her assets, she's trustworthy. She's a positive influence. She's a hard worker. She's a planner. She is protective. her achievements. She meets the needs of her home. She invests for her household. She keeps herself in shape. She helps her husband become successful. Her attitude, delightful, healthy, compassionate, unselfish, public. Her applause from her family, from her husband, from God's word, from her works. Andrew, I want you to know that I celebrate you throughout every day, but on tonight especially, I want to say that I celebrate you because of who you are. I appreciate you because you allow me to breathe. I tell you from the very beginning that that's the big difference in my life, is that I can be my best. I don't have to worry about whether or not people get me or all those other, I can just be. And I'm excited about being able to really release now that we're now for the first year, this will be our first year as truly husband and wife, where there's no more protecting me, me standing back and letting me finish up, but now we can go out and do what God has assigned us to do, because we're unique as a couple, and I'm excited about that. I want to tell you that I appreciate you for how you love my children. I appreciate the relationship that you've developed with my children and their mom. I thank you all. Because again, that's something that's not usual, but it's a mark of who you are. And so, babe, we got the world in our hands. I promise you that everything God has laid out, that it's simply us walking it out. Now faith, not later. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. And those dreams that you have in your mind, they're already done. And so I love, love, love doing life with you. I love the way that you love me. I love the way that we are together. And the best is yet to come. And so to that end, I want to bring up this lady that I have the utmost respect for. You're talking about someone that is the 17th woman of color in the 56-year history of the Mary Kay Incorporated company, in the 56-year history of the company to be a national sales director. You're talking about someone that achieved that, debuted as a national sales director as the youngest, still to this day. And I'm excited to say that she'll be retiring as the youngest woman of color and debuting as a Emeritus. And that's something, as we approach Black History Month, to celebrate. Yes. But more importantly, I want to bring forth this person that we all honor tonight and really shared from the heart. And I appreciate that as a husband, that the love that you guys have demonstrated and that you've shared. Because listen, we've had some moments as we made this last run, as we're closing out the year, with some foolishness taking place. But thank God that it's only allowed us just to show our strength as a couple. Because when people try to get in between husband and wife, that's a real problem.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
But thank God that we've had that opportunity to also experience how we cling to each other.
Yes.
Because that's the example that we have opportunity to move forward with and be able to give to the world and give people that opportunity to see that now. You can really, really love publicly and love and grow and challenge and truly be strength for one another. So, baby, I love you. Please come up and take the mic and do what you do.